Well worth staying out for tonight's RPM as we look at the West Country's Love Directory and at a theatre group working with kids in the St Paul's area of Bristol. We also feature a little virtuoso performance from one of the best bass players in the country, and there's local music too from the Sydneys a bit later on, and Stroud's Custom Software right away. I explained last week RPM this year is pledged to seek out all sorts of strange new worlds and civilizations, especially in terms of nightlife. Now this week we look at a very specialist area, the Singles Club, which along with marriage bureaus and introduction agencies all over the country have been given star ratings in this new book, The Love Directory, written and researched right here in Bristol.
Well, what we'll do first then is we'll go through this little form together. Yeah. Now this is not for other clients' eyes, it's just for us.
Yeah.
So first of all then, name. So that's Peter, isn't it?
It is indeed, Peter Davis.
Right. How old are you, Peter?
I'm 41.
Right. Are you divorced, single?
I'm divorced.
Yes. And
so I've been on my own for 4 years now.
Right. Now, the sort of person that you want to meet, so you probably want a lady slightly younger?
Possibly.
So yes. What should we say, 35 to, what, 45?
Yes, fine.
Yeah, so it's just a guide, really. I mean,
yeah.
Age, well, what is age, really? Some people do get a bit uptight about it.
Well, I don't think it matters that much.
No. Now, if you want to make use of the service, what we'll do is do a short tape on video together. Mm-hmm. And then you can select from the videotape library perhaps some clients you'd like to meet.
Are you lonesome tonight? Do you miss me tonight? Are you sorry we drifted apart? Does your memory stray to a bright summer day?
I was in the situation of being in a room with four walls and nothing else. And I think there are millions of people in that situation. I think it's very sad because they could, if they made a little effort, do something about it. And I went along to a couple of solo clubs and I enjoyed it and I got a good social life out of it. And consequently I thought, well, why doesn't somebody do a guide? So then I thought, well, I'm in the ideal situation, I'm on my own, I'll do it, and I have.
Filled with pain, shall I come back again?
Obviously, a lot of people have come unstuck by their experiences with agencies.
Yes, I came across that. People came unstuck, particularly people came unstuck when ladies joined agencies which give out their full name and address. So that I, as a single person, was given the full name and address of quite a few ladies who, to all intents and purposes, are living on their own. And whenever I met them for a date, they were, quite frankly, terrified.
That's it. Make yourself comfortable, if you can.
Yes, okay.
Right, it'll all be over in 3 minutes. Peter, if money was no object, where in the world do you think you would go for a holiday?
Well, I think somebody told me just recently about the Seychelles, and I think that sounds rather lovely. Desert island on your own.
Beautiful sunshine, beautiful beaches, absolutely wonderful, yes. I should think.
Sounds marvellous.
It does.
What about if you go out for an evening meal? What type of restaurant do you like to go to?
The fees vary, and they vary enormously. From a dating agency that'll charge £3... to an agency which can charge, I think it's £115 for interview, enrolment and the first year's membership, plus, if they introduce you to Mr. or Mrs. Wright, a £450 per person marriage fee, which is astronomical as a wedding present, in my opinion.
And they give guarantees that they will match you with the right price?
I haven't yet come across an agency which will give you a guarantee. Nor one that will give you a refund if you get a divorce. I think there's an awful lot of people in this world who, at the end of the working day, they go home to four walls and they've got nothing else, and they don't like to admit they've got nothing else. And I think the clubs do a good job for those sort of people.
I'd never even thought about joining a singles club before. I moved down from Gloucester with my job and I came on my own, new to the area. I found Bristol was unfriendly, really, because most of the people I knew, they were married, engaged, whatever, they all had their own little communities. And I just felt very alone. So I joined as a last resort. I saw an advert in the paper and one day took my courage in my hands and just rang up.
Well, I lost my wife nearly 2 years ago. And, you know, I tried to pick up the threads afterwards. But I found that the world seemed to be comprised of couples. I felt the odd man out.
After a couple of painful years, my husband left me after 36 and a half years. I am disabled, and I was almost ready for a wheelchair, and my husband suddenly got bored of me. He couldn't cope with somebody who he thought was going to be tied down to somebody in a chair for the rest of their lives, and left me.
You form friendships when you're at school. Those friends get married, you get married, and you are walking in a channel. Suddenly something happens in your life where you're no longer a double act, you're a single person, and you have to find other people who are in the same position.
I'm not saying that anybody who goes along to a club is going to find their knight in shining armour or the page three girl or whatever it is, because they're not. Life isn't like that. But if they go along just to enjoy it and not expecting to meet Mr. or Mrs. Wright, if they do, then that's a bonus.
I didn't know what to expect. I thought probably that the first man I'd talk to would be after me.
Is your heart filled with pain? Shall I come back? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome tonight?
Thank you.
The Sydney's Live at Moe's Club in Bath. And now to the RPM Masterclass, because anyone with half an ear open to modern pop music will realise that there's been a big change of style over the last couple of years in the way people are playing the humble bass guitar. And probably one of the best of these new performers is the far from humble Mark King of Level 42. Mr. King has very little to be humble about when it comes to the bass guitar, as you shall see, after we see him in action on stage. Stop there for a second. Right. Tell us exactly how this style of bass playing began.
Well, it's a very old style, really, and it began, I think, probably by a guy called Larry Graham in America, who professes to have done it, like, years and years and years ago, back sort of 40s, early 50s, because he used to play bass for his mum, who played gospel piano, and where they didn't have drums, he used to play more of a rhythmic thing, and that's why he started sort of slapping the bass, so that he was still playing bass lines, but making it more sort of drummy as well. So you get the best of both worlds, really.
As opposed to what style? I mean, what was the common style before this one really took over?
Well, I mean, the common style is finger style, or plectrum. I mean, but basically you associate basses like sort of walking style, that sort of thing, you know. And it's very much like a foundational thing. And there isn't a great deal of syncopation in there. It was very much the upper half of the rhythm section, if you like.
But this seemed to be a great revolution. I mean, about 5 years ago, everybody, well, it's true, isn't it? I mean, everybody seemed to be playing in this new style.
That's right. I think that it sort of did come to life then, but mainly more because it was suddenly fashionable in Europe to do that, you know. Americans have been doing it for a long time. Guys like Louis Johnson, Stanley Clarke, Larry Graham, they're sort of very good thumb players. But it wasn't as popular because they were playing it in more of an elitist music, whereas now it's come to the fore because you hear it all the time in popular music, pop music, and that's the difference. This is why it's suddenly become fashionable to do it. And now with sampling synthesizers, this is synthesizers that you can actually play a note recorded in a synthesizer and play that note. Guys, producers like Trevor Horn, this sort of thing, you hear it a lot on records now, so you hear that sort of... It's not real, you know, it's not real.
What about the speed then? Where does the speed come from in your playing?
Columbia? Cut like a dream. The speed thing is just... I myself began as a drummer, and sort of the independence of hands, thing. Speed isn't really important, only in as much as it's a way of expressing more what you can do. Also, something that I can do very easily, so I tend to go as fast as I can. Equally as fulfilling bass lines can be some. That sort of tempo is great too. But the dexterity of speed makes people go woo and earns you nice lots of money and stuff. So speed for me has always been easy. Like that sort of thing is very easy to do.
See what's
and doesn't it look
is.
Flash?
Don't go to be all
right. Yeah, and you want to make a bit of like when you, just as you finished your stab, get straight back off, or you know, chat.
Do that one as well.
Right, but it's just getting those really quick. Oh no, no,
don't do that again.
Do you want to step in?
Yeah.
We're Avon Touring Theatre Company, and part of our yearly programme is to do a three-week residency every year. On this occasion, particularly because we're trying to expand our role in this particular community in Montpellier, and this sort of area of Bristol, we've brought kids in from various local youth clubs.
You're accusing us, so you've got to say yes, you did.
And this particular project this evening is Sefton Park Youth Club on Ashley Down Road. And this is really just a video for Sefton Park to make themselves with us, showing what they do. And they divide into basically graffiti art, which they take very seriously, breakdancing and popping, and toasting, reggae toasting, and rapping, that kind of thing.
And you've got something that we did it.
I just want to keep forgetting.
Yeah.
Well, so, you say it, right? So it's best if you start.
You start. Then I got to say it, then you got to say it, then I got to say it, then you got to say it, then I got to say it again.
Who finishes, don't you?
I got to finish, I got to say it three times, and you got to say it too.
All right, then.
Get ready, then I get ready. To go to Sefton Park and I do the boogie.
Some are pop, some are brick, some are water pumpy.
We play rubber dub and sometimes funky.
We are white, we are black and a Pakistani. We all live together in a happy family. And this is what we call the Sefton Posse.
It's all taken very seriously. A lot of it has to be done sort of illicitly late at night on various back garage walls and so on. But the particular three tonight, they've all got their street names. And whenever they've finished one of their graffitis, they sign it with what they call their tag. What they're doing tonight is acting out a thing called a burn-off, which is when two teams of breakdancers vie against each other. So they started off by sort of picking out a quarrel, and then they go forward one by one and play against each other.
Beat Street, the king of the beat. You see him rocking that beat from across the street. And Beat Street is a lesson too, because you can't let the streets beat you. Words to describe all the beauty of life you give. And if the world was yours to do over, I know you'd paint a better place to live, where the colors would swirl and the boys and girls can grow in peace and harmony, and where murals stand on walls so grand as far as the eyes are able to see. I never knew art till I saw your face. And there'll never be one to take your place. Cause each and every time you touch a spray paint can, Michelangelo's soul controls your hands. Then serenades of blue and red, and the beauty of the rainbow fills your head. Crescendo colors play in tune. Man, why oh why'd you have to die so soon? All tears fall for all you've done, trying to be a good father to your only son. But now who's gonna make sure that he's fed? Put a shirt on his back and a roof overhead. Tell me who's gonna dream the impossible dream of the beautiful cities and the islands. Dreams when your words are brought into being. All that the ghetto stopped to conceal.
So much. Good night.